in the cathedral chapel for our service of Compline by candlelight. I want to begin just by saying thank you to Owen Chan for his wonderful recital on the organ that we've just heard, and to say a few things about the things that are happening over the next few days. The first of these is that tomorrow afternoon we'll have our usual theology session, tea, cookies, and a chance to discuss the deeper things of faith and life. And tomorrow we'll be thinking about, appropriately at this time of year, the identity of Jesus, and in particular his relationship to God the Father. And that's something that we're exploring as we explore the meaning of the Creed. And we'll get dug into all those early debates in the early centuries and find out why it was all so controversial and why we've ended up where we are now. After that, at 6:30, there'll be an art and architectural tour of the chapel for just 20 minutes to learn a bit about the art history of this wonderful building, ending at the Light of the World at 6:30 tomorrow. And that's quite useful if you're bringing people in to dinner. Will be finished in very good time for you to get across and take any guests into dinner. It's a nice thing to do before that. On Sunday, we have a very special service. We'll be celebrating Candlemas, the feast of the presentation of Christ in the temple. And it's called Candlemas because that's the day on which we bless the church's candles for the whole year. And so we'll have a special service of communion by candlelight, and we'll be joined by Holly Adams from the Methodist Church, who'll be preaching for us. And it'll be a wonderful occasion at 5:30 on Sunday, our principal service of the week, communion by candlelight for Candlemas. And then, just as next week begins, on Monday at Max's lunch, we have our wonderful engineering colleague, Jingyi Yang, who will be talking about using origami to design solar arrays for satellites. And she'll be bringing a lot of her own origami art to show off to us and to show us how she uses that ancient art form to address some of the most contemporary of engineering challenges and problems of sending things into outer space. So I'm very much looking forward to that. 1:00 on Monday, with a free lunch thrown in, and just 50 minutes for a chance to hear her and to ask questions and discuss about what it is that she does. After our service today, as usual, there will be port and hot chocolate in the college bar. And all of you, whether you're members of Keble or not, are very welcome to come across and join us. It would be lovely to get the chance to say hello to each one of you individually and to see you there. If you're not sure of the way, just follow the crowd and we'll be pointing people in that general direction. So I hope to see you there. But for now, let us keep still and silent. And for 20 minutes, the choir will lead us in our service, allowing the peace and calm of this ancient office to wash over us in the middle of a busy week.
The Lord Almighty grant us a quiet night and a perfect end.
Amen.
Brethren, be sober, be vigilant, because your adversary, the devil, as a roaring lion, walketh about, seeking whom he may devour. Whom resist steadfast in the faith. But thou, O Lord, have mercy upon us.
Thanks be to God.
Our help is in the name of the Lord,
who hath made
God Almighty.
The Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost, that we have sinned in thought, word, and deed, through our own grievous fault. Wherefore we pray, God, to have mercy upon us. Almighty God, have mercy upon us. Forgive us for our sins and deliver us from evil. Confirm and strengthen us in all goodness, and bring us to life everlasting, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
May the Almighty and Merciful God grant you pardon and remission of all your sins, time for amendment of life, and the grace and comfort of his Holy Spirit.
Amen.
O God, make speed to save us.
O Lord, make haste to help us.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Ghost.
As it was in the beginning, now and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Into thy hands, O Lord, I commend my spirit.
light and our darkness, we beseech thee, O Lord. And by thy great mercy, defend us from all perils and dangers of this night. For the love of thy only Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ.
Amen.
We will lay us down in peace and take our